Just building a nest in the prickles there.
The baby that was out yesterday afternoon.
Checking out the campsite.
The other one's even smaller.
Just looking across above the wallaby who's in the bushes just underneath. There's one of the several fishermen. Just going back inside for a moment for a bit of a drink. All the fishermen are actually sitting up having a cup of tea or a beer. Photograph of them. A great bunch of musos, very friendly campers, been coming here for years. All of their various illnesses and ailments. This is Anson's Bay. Another shackville place, but very upmarket. $100,000 for a block. People from all over are buying in. We just spoke to the real estate agent looking for Policeman's Point. Quite a deep little bay. Shacks around there and boats. Reasonably substantial places. One place had two Land Cruisers.
Very cheap, cheap, cheaping.
No, they brought up their babies and moved out.
Mm. Now we're coming down to there.
Well, here.
That's where we
Here's
are.
The lighthouse.
There's the Eddystone Lighthouse, lots of other visitors. Interesting little boat ramp out into the Pacific. Massive crystals in the granite, veins, very, there's a nice pegmatite vein. Really rough. there's three houses. In the days when it was man, that's the main house, obviously. Beautiful stonework, and it's a beautiful day for looking at beautiful stonework. It's still going around. Looks like a giant Russian Easter egg. I'll have to climb up. Saw it flashing last night from our campsite on the beach. A couple of flashes and then 4 seconds. Just lighting up the clouds, it was. The beach down to Ant.
I don't know what mountain
is there. Nice long beach. This is looking down. Bay of Fires, that beach. We camped up there last night, over that, way over the point, because you could see the lighthouse only lighting up the clouds. And there's George's Island off there. George's Island, more rocks. That would be one of the most remote one we've been to. One of the nicest spots. There's always a grave.
18 months.
Just a bit further north towards Green's Beach, must be one of the most beautiful boat launching ramps ever. And that shack has a view. Ask for a nicer day. There's the water supply for two more shacks. Shacks with a view. They all nestle into the scrub and then just pop down and throw in a magic. Beautiful colours in the water with Polaroid sunglasses.
There's a big Pacific gull juvenile, look.
Alright.
See the size of him compared with the little...
That's the little fellow.
Bill, he's eating the fish.
And there's the other one. Whole fish. He's got a hook
feet. Yeah, he's sucking it up. Whoa.
Oh, yeah. Well, go for each other.
Come in to get him, but he got it down.
And watch the lighthouse flashing on the horizon at night. Oh, we've spent another couple of hours there and $50 and stones and books. Well, it tracks close to the falls. So we might have to make do with a view from here. It's right there. Well, it gets better as we walk down the dangerous landslip track and trees down, etc. this is from 835 metres up, just near Ralph's Falls. We should be able to see the ocean. That's some of the rolling country we've been driving through. And we probably went through Ringarooma, or some of that country over there even. Or is it not?
We came through up there on the main road the other day.
Yeah, we went past that, going across west to east. We're near, not very far from Mount Victoria and Mount Albert. And there's one of the forestry coops. I've seen a lot of those scatter around the hills. At least they're not all connected together. Old Robin Gray's been everywhere. And here's Norm's lookout down the same valley. It's claimed to be the highest falls in the Tasmania. They even said a free fall, but it's not actually free falling. Once upon a time, all these rocks were lying down flat. This is where the falls start and fly over the edge. Lovely crystal. Just coming to the top of the cliff line here. After seeing lovely wattle. Rocky terrain.
Oh, that one's a lovely one. You can see it from here.
There's another Waratah just next to the echidna. Echidna with a view. It's like the dry lichen we had in the South Coast track. It's very hard. And there's a little silvery top pine growing up out of the rocks. This is lovely and soft. It's like a plantation.
Yeah.
There.
Put the myrtle over the other side. Biggie on the far hill.
Yeah. Just coming out of the forest of casuarina, sandalwood, myrtle to a rocky prominence, a view right over 500 odd metres away from the falls, and it's dead calm in the amongst the trees. This is Nash's Gorge. Very spectacular. Saturday morning market day, and there's a power blackout all the way down the coast for 8 hours. This is in the middle of St. Helens.
I asked her about if she could do them, remember?
Yeah.
I listened to you last time.
Oh, you did appoint.
I took it to the jewellers. It was $95 or that.
Oh.
That turned out quite extreme.
So we can't do them because you can lose them.
Well, I found down at Ishtar's. I got them in the car.
We can't get our stuff wet, eh?
Yeah.
I mean, it's not that important that we... Well,
this is the Bay of Fives. We're right up as far as we can go up the coast. The Greens. We're going to work our way back down along all these beautiful beaches. There's a blackout all the way down the coast and in town. Hopefully the sun will come out now and again. There's little shacks and van places all the way down the coast. There's a very good road. We might see a whale if we look out there long enough.
What are you photographing there?
Whales today. The shacks from the north where we just had lunch.